Trina is with us in Oklahoma City. Hi, Trina. How are you?
Hi, Dave. I'm good. How are you?
Better than I deserve. What's up?
Dave, I've been listening to your show for probably about 2 months now, and I am wondering how I can get my husband on board to begin the baby steps. I have mentioned it to him several times. Several people I know have gone through your program. And I am very interested, and I am just trying to get him on board. I wrote down a lot of our numbers, and I'm sick of being sick and tired.
Are you the one doing the bills?
It's probably half and half. He pays half, I pay half.
No, I'm saying who's writing them? Are you writing the checks?
Yes, I write the checks.
Yeah, that's what I mean by doing the bills, write the checks. Okay. So I'm not saying who's contributing. You're both contributing, obviously. How long have you been married?
We're fixing to celebrate our 17th year.
Yay, good for you guys. That's fun. Okay. Well, the thing is this. You probably figured out, like I have and my wife has, that most of us guys are a little thick. We do not get subtlety. You kind of have to just say it. My mind reading skills suck.
Right.
Okay. And I'm sure you think you've said it, but what I want you to do, you guys got kids?
Yes.
Okay. When the kids are in bed, asleep, I want you to turn off the television and sit down at the kitchen table and have a talk about life.
Right.
And like to and go, honey, I need my man to step up beside me here and look at this with me. I'm not asking you to become a nerd, but I think we work too hard to be as broke as we are, and I think we can do better. And I need you to look at this with me for a minute. What's happening is you got the bug bit a little bit listening to the show or somewhere. Somebody gave you a book or something, and you've been doing these drive-bys with him, these verbal drive-bys where you just dropped a thing, and he's not going to get it where you do that. You're going to have to sit down with the TV off and the kids asleep, looking into his eyes going, this matters to me. This man loves his wife, and when she does that, he's going to respond to that.
Right. Okay. Well, I've not done it that, like you said.
You're right.
That, but,
you haven't. And he hasn't heard you.
I have told, and I'm like, we need to do this. This
I know.
Is something important.
I know. But I know. But you're not hearing me. You're not hearing me. Okay? Here's the thing. Sometimes in communication in marriage, you say something, and for you, out of a scale of 1 to 10, it's an 8. And the circumstances and the way you say it conveys to him a 2.
Right. Okay.
He's hearing 1.2. He's hearing 1.2 right now. And you're carrying around an 8 going, why can't he hear this? And it's the circumstances and the tone. When my wife sits down and says, this is very important to me, I might disagree, but I'm going to listen, and we're going to have a real intellectual marriage discussion about this. I really think we need to look at this. This matters to me. That's different than we're driving down the road, I'm dodging traffic, the radio's on, and she says, I heard this guy on the radio, I think we ought to do this. That doesn't work. I don't hear that. That's just more white noise.
Right.
I'm just telling you how guys' brains work. We're pretty simple animals.
Right. So keep it simple, stupid.
Yeah.
I have a second question.
And not cluttered. Real clear.
Right.
Okay.
I have a second question. I am not familiar with the baby steps other than just what I've heard from your show. Mm-hmm. And I have sat down and I have crunched numbers. Mm-hmm. And I don't really know, where to begin. I've included every little bitty thing I can think of brought down to my daughter's dance tuition every month.
Good. Here's what's happening. You're trying to figure out, you're looking in the rear view mirror to do your budget. And that's a good place to get information. But the proper way to do your budget, once you gather that information, and so it's good that you gathered the information, the proper way is to look out the windshield. We need to say, okay, before this coming month begins, here comes June. Before June gets here, I'm going to figure out what June's income is. take-home pay, and I'm going to spend it on June's bills. Every dollar has an assignment before June gets here, and then we are going to agree to stick to that, and then we can start with the money we find in the budget making some progress, and that's where you do the baby steps. So what you'll do is go to everydollar.com, download the Every Dollar app for your phone. It's free. You can put it on your phone. You can put it on his phone, and you guys can talk about it that way. And you can sit together and lay out your budget for June. And that's a good way to start the conversation. And then the baby steps are what you do when you squeeze money out of your monthly budget and you say, okay, June, I've got $300 left. I need to give it a name. Okay, what are we going to do with it? Well, your first baby step is you save $1,000. And your next baby step is you start paying off all your debts except your home, listing them smallest to largest and working them off in that order. So I'll send you a copy of the blockbuster bestseller, The Total Money Makeover. We've sold about 7 million of those books, so they've helped somewhere around 15, 20 million people. And if you hold on, Madison will pick up. I'll send you a copy of that book. But you jump online and download the app, the Every Dollar app, and start putting together your budget. And The Total Money Makeover is the step-by-step guide on exactly how to do the baby steps, what not to do, what to do, step-by-step. It's a process book. It's exactly what to do and why to do it. And that's why it's been so popular, because it shows people a clear plan that we can look at and both of us can agree to with the kids asleep and the TV off. And we're planning our life. Jesus said, your treasure's where your heart is. What are we doing with our treasures? Oh, it's going to stupid stuff. Oh, we got to stop that. We need to plan our future. We want our kids to go to school. We want to retire with dignity. We want to be able to give with outrageous generosity. We want to change our family tree. None of that is stupid stuff. But boy, we all buy some stupid stuff, don't we?